Hi and welcome to a tutorial on frames. Frames are a new feature in Web Core 1.3. Let's first look at what are frames in general, because they have been part of Delphi and the VCL for a long time. And after that, we're going to look at a bundled example that's part of the TMS Web Core installation, so you can have a look at the whole thing in depth after watching this tutorial and experiment with the feature on your own before including it in your own applications. But before opening up Delphi and looking at a new VCL forms application in order to motivate the frames for TMS Web Core, let's define what a frame is. All of us have worked with a text processor like Word or back in the day WordPerfect, and these things had building blocks. And building block is just what a frame is. So a frame, like a form, is a container for other components, meaning you can group your components and store them under a name, which becomes a class derived from tframe. And then you have the opportunity from that form that you place your frame on to access all the graphical controls and the methods of that frame. So frames have become very, very popular in the VCL to encapsulate common functionality that you need on more than one form. As it says here on the slide, in many ways, a frame is a customized component that consists of many other graphical components. One word of warning, do not confuse frames with form inheritance. In order to figure out what form inheritance does and which advantages it has for you, for your development cycle, have a look at the form inheritance video, because form inheritance is also now a new feature of Web Core. Here I created a new VCL forms application, and what I can do is, for example, I can take an edit and a button. Let's implement some code for the button. The edit1.text is being set, and I'm going to set date to string of the current time. So here, if you click the button, the date is being written into the edit control. Fancy functionality, I know, but we're just here to illustrate frames. So let's say you want this functionality in multiple forms. You can encapsulate this functionality inside of a frame. The VCL offers a template to create frames. So in order to do that, you add a new element, individual files, and then here you find the VCL frame somewhere right here. Oh, sorry, right here. Okay. And that opens up a different designer without any caption or anything, because it's just part of a form that is being illustrated here. And of course, the source code looks different, because now you derive from tframe and unit one, of course, you derive off tform. So in order to copy over our functionality, I'm going to copy both components and I'm going to insert them on the frame. And of course, we have to create the event. I can copy the giant block of source code as well over. And now, if we compile the application, it still works. But if we start our application, of course, the form is empty. And now you can use your frame functionality. You click from the tuple, the frames, you click. And here is frame two, I cancel. This is the name of our frame. So if we were to call this, for example, the frame is going to be called name date frame, like that. And then you go back here and you insert the frame. You see that it's named date frame. You say okay. And here you see the block of the frame. You have to, of course, be very careful how you specify the size of the frame and how you align everything. You can use anchors, alignments, etc. to make it all work. That's basically the principle of a frame. The nice thing that you have available is this is an object on your form. So this is called date frame one. So in order to, for example, initialize it, you could do in the form create date frame one dot edit1.text equals test. And then you run your application And you see that even from outside of your frame, you can use these. And then the functionality is still there. That functionality comes from the frame. Let's have a look how it works in TMS Web Core. After creating a new TMS web application, we could look for a TMS web frame component, but actually TMS decided to use the exact same object class or the same class, tframe. So what we need to do is we need to create file, new, other, and we actually pick the exact same template. So we pick the VCL frame from the new items dialog, click OK. And here we now can place, just like we did with our VCL frame, we click and use the same components as before. There's one thing to be careful about though. We develop for a web application, and because we use the VCL frame control, we still could add non-web controls. So we would be able to add a T button to this frame, which would lead to complications later on. So you have to be a little bit careful just to pick the web controls for this frame. But here the functionality, just the same. I double click the button, web edit one dot text equals date to string now. So exactly the same functionality as before. And on unit one, we drop the frame component. And there you see frame two. And of course we can rename the frame using the object inspector. I'm going to name the frame date frame just like before. Go here, drop the frame, insert it. And now I run the web application. I get the application with the frame in the middle of the form. I click the button and you see the functionality is there outside of the frame. And of course, just like with the VCL application, you can go to the onCreate event. The frame is web edit one. You have full code completion, so I couldn't even make that mistake actually while recording this video. Web edit one dot text equals test. And now we run the application again. There you go, the default value test comes out of the main form and the functionality out of the frame is also still there. TMS Web comes with a wonderful example in the demo basics folder in the frames directory, TMS Web Frames. And there you can learn more about frames, how to set it all up, because here you have the main form with two list boxes and two arrows in the middle. And you can switch the elements from the left to the right and from the right to the left. So for example, here you have oranges, you put them over, bananas, you move them to the right. And of course you can move them to the left. And also the enabled and disabled state of the buttons is being maintained. So what happens in the frame? What happens in your application? Pretty easy. If you open up the frame, you see that the whole functionality of the list boxes and clicking the arrows is actually handled inside of the frame. So your application can concentrate on simply providing the values, initializing the frame, and that's all you need to take care of. All the functionality, how the elements are being moved over from left to right, from right to left, is encapsulated inside of your frame. So the frame actually makes it really powerful if you have things that you want to use over and over and over again on different forms or web forms. You can basically wrap that up in a frame and thus use the same code over and over and over again. Thank you so much for your interest in using frames with TMS Web Core. As I mentioned before, we also have another video on form inheritance, a new feature of version 1.3, which also goes into the same direction as frames to give you the ability to encapsulate code that you use more than once and also to build your own set of forms for multiple applications, not only one that you use more than once, to inherit from those forms and make common programming tasks easier. See you soon.